Hello, I'm Beelzebub, and welcome to my channel. This is a video I've been wanting to make for a while now, but I wanted to make sure I got it right. So I kind of just sat on it for a couple of months, letting it percolate until I finally actually got to work on it. But on a few occasions, I've been accused of being a nihilist because I'm an atheist. But is this really the case? Well, let's look at the simplest thing to explain in the question, which is, what is atheism? Well, as I and every other atheist ever has said, atheism is the lack of belief in a god or gods. It truly is that simple, and anything else is part of an individual atheist's personal philosophy. Nihilism is a little more tricky. There are 6 forms of nihilism, so let's look at each one, and I'll give my answer to the question at the end of this video. First up, we have metaphysical nihilism. Metaphysical nihilism posits that concrete objects and physical constructs might not exist in the possible world, or that even if there exists possible worlds that contain some concrete objects, there is at least one that contains only abstract objects. Essentially, this is the definition that says nothing exists. I won't say for certain that no atheist is a metaphysical nihilist, because I can't. There very well may be an atheist out there who is also a metaphysical nihilist. But I am not one, so let's move on and talk about epistemological nihilism. Epistemological nihilism, other than being the most fun or difficult to pronounce, is a form of skepticism in which all knowledge is accepted as being unable to be confirmed true. Once again, I won't say that no atheist is an epistemological nihilist, because I can't. And once again, it's not something that I identify with, because the way I interact with the world is that there are true things. I exist, and that's verifiable, you're looking at me right now. You on the other side of a computer exist, and you can verify that much the same way. And the world around us exists. So moving on. Up next is mereological nihilism, also called compositional nihilism. This is the position that objects with proper parts do not exist. Not only objects in space, but also objects existing in time do not have any temporal parts. And only basic building blocks without parts exist. And thus, the world we see and experience, full of objects with parts, is a product of human misperception. An example, if we could see clearly, we would not perceive compositive parts. I'm not gonna lie to you guys, I couldn't make heads or tails of this one. Even after watching a few videos explaining it, I really couldn't wrap my head around it. But I did leave a link to one of the better and shorter videos I found explaining it. So if you want to maybe have your question of what the hell is mereological nihilism answered, that may end up being your best bet. However, it doesn't apply to me, so I'm moving on. Existential nihilism is the belief that life has no intrinsic meaning or value. I think this is what theists are talking about when they call atheists nihilists. This and moral nihilism, but I'm getting a little ahead of myself, so let's table moral nihilism for a minute and finish up with existential nihilism. But this actually is a form that I identify with. I don't believe that anything has intrinsic value, only the subjective value or meaning that I or someone else puts on a subject. Whether I'm the subject, another person, an animal, or an object, the meaning or value placed on the subject is subjective. But while this does apply to me, it may not apply to another atheist. So let's move on to moral nihilism. Moral nihilism is also called ethical nihilism and is the meta-ethical view that morality does not exist as something inherent to objective reality. Here's another form of nihilism I identify with. I don't see the world through a morally objective lens. Just, you know, these lenses. There's my bad joke for the video. And I come to that conclusion by looking at the moralities of different cultures. But even shared morals are still subjective. So, again, while it applies to me, it may not apply to another atheist. And finally, we've got political nihilism. Political nihilism follows the characteristic nihilist's rejection of non-rationalized or non-proven assertions. In this case, the necessity of the most fundamental societal and political structures, such as government, family, and law. It's pretty straightforward. It's just the rejection of political and social institutions. But while this may apply to another atheist, it doesn't apply to me. So now I've explained the six forms of nihilism about as well as I can. Getting back to the question of the video, are atheists nihilistic? I actually answered this question at the beginning of the video when I defined atheism. So no, atheism is not inherently nihilistic. An atheist can be nihilistic, but that would be separate from their atheism. Atheism only answers one question, and one question only, and that question is, do you believe in any god or gods? So anyone who claims atheism is nihilistic is either ignorant or misinformed, or they're just straight up lying. And I know the thesaurus will list atheism as a synonym for nihilism, but that's wrong. And the thesaurus gets it wrong for the same reasons I just laid out seconds ago. That's going to do it for me, though. Tell me what you guys think. Do you think that atheists are nihilistic? And if so, why do you think that? If you enjoyed the video, please leave a like and subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. Don't forget to follow me on Twitter, linked below, to keep up with all my comings and goings. Take it easy, everyone, and I'll see you all in the next one.